I know if we talk about bedroom, most of you, your ears is really packed, get bigger and much more interested in this topic because that's wow, amazing. So in this video, we will talk about how Filipina really act in the bedroom. Welcome back again to our kid channel. Once again, this is Tang, your ordinary Filipina. For today's video, we were gonna talk about dominant or submissive. What kind of partner are you? Are you a dominant or a submissive? Which do you prefer? The rule of the relationship. Dominant or submissive? Well, we will find out why I'm talking about dominant and submissive topic in this video. So without further ado, let's start. Before you entering the relationship for Filipina, what do you expect when you are dating a Filipina? Is Filipina submissive or dominant? In some other videos and other vloggers, they often says that Filipinas are submissive. Is this true? I need to ask myself for that. Is this true thing? That Filipina is submissive? Well, let's see in this video how an average Filipina act based on education. Number one, daily life at home. We often knows that Filipinas are the best wife. Filipina cook for you, care for the house, care for the kids, and take care of you, of course. Filipina experience also to make laundry. All the household chores that a wife can do, Filipina will always do that because we both know that Filipina are really flexible person. But there are some things that Filipina will depend to their partner, just like the man's work, like repair things in the home, making construction in the home. That will be the husband's responsibility to do so, right? It's not really all the time that you will see that a husband will help you with all household chores. If they will help you, then that's only a bonus, you know. There is some situation the husband always gonna think that the life of a wife is easy. Staying in the house the whole day. So in some situation, husband will always say, wishing that I hope they're the one staying at home and the wife will do the work every day. And then one time, the wish granted. And then the husband do all laundry, take care for the kids, cook for the kids, clean the house, make laundry, and anything. And then after that, he felt so tired and said, it's not really easy to be a housewife. Yes, of course, it's not easy. People always think that being a housewife is easy, but you are wrong. Because being a housewife is the best or the most difficult yet wonderful work for us Filipina, because or for us women, because we choose to take care of our family, to take care of our husband. So you can call it submission if you want. It depends on you how you will act in that situation, of course. So just think what you want to think about that. It's either you want it to be dominant or submissive. What kind of rule you want in your life with your partner? It's only you can answer for that. Because it's only you knows what you really want to do in your life with your partner. It should be dominant or submissive. It's up to you. The next one is life outside your home. Yes, it should have life outside your home. It's not only in your house, because here in Filipina expect that you have plan in your relationship with her. So there are so many things that might considered that you will do together. But in this some situation, I do believe that other Filipina will just depend on what is your decision might be. And they always want that you are the leader. They only will follow what you want. The question is, what is the role of the Filipina in that situation? Submissive or dominant? If you will go outside, your Filipina will just depend on the foods that you order, the things that you will buy. What? Why is that there are situations like that? Is it because some other thing that we Filipinas think about, we're not the one who is holding the budgeting for everything, you know? It's only you, because since you are the one who have money or who have income. So we feel that we have no right to demand for what we want because we only depending on you. It's always that you are the one who always tell we will go here, we will go there, without the opinion of your Filipina if she want go there or not. So it all depends on you. But the most important thing in this part is if you will go outside and buy some things that it's really needed at home, then I prefer you will do it with your Filipina, because the Filipina most time they are not looking for the quality of the product, because they are looking for the quantity. Cheaper. Yes, we always look for the price, which is cheaper. If this one is cheaper, we always compare it. So we don't mind the quality because we always mind the quantity. So if you want save more money for that, then bring your Filipina. Number three, budget with money issue. Yeah, here in the Philippines, we raised with the culture of it's the wife should hold the money that the husband earned from work. So if it's time for the salary day, the husband should give the salary to the wife, because that's the culture. The wife will be the one who will budget the money. The wife will be the one who will divide it, and it's the wife decision how much she will give to you. There is some situation like that. There are situations ganin that some other wife here in the Philippines, they will get all the money from the husband and then they will just leave for something. But because there are so much many things that need to be budgeted in that money. Rice, allowance for the kids, bills, foods, and anything. So every month there is a budgeting in the house, what is needed, how much is needed. So how about you, Tinkles? Would you prefer to do that, to give your salary with your wife and let her be the one to handle the cost for the whole month? Do you want to follow the culture here in the Philippines? Well, if you don't want, that still depends on you. Because there are all, most of foreigners' mindset is that maybe if I will give all the money to my Filipina will run away and leave me for nothing. So how could you be happy if your mindset is like that? How can the relationship will be successful if your mindset is like that, that your Filipina will run away after you give all the money that you have? Right? So in this, making this kind of relationship, especially with money issue, that trust is should be, and should you should be committed to trust to your wife in this kind of situation. But yeah, we cannot deny that you have some thought in your mind in that way, and you don't want to be left for nothing. But can you just try to trust your Filipino or your wife in that way? Is it really hard to trust us? That's all your opinion. We have different culture, and the culture here in the Philippines is very big difference from your country. Because I believe most of the couples in your country is both have work, right? You have work and the wife have work, so you have no time for each other, because if you come back from work, both of you are tired, no one will cook for you for dinner because your wife also is tired from work, so all you need to do is to order, to eat, or maybe you already eat before you came home, so there's no quality time because both of you are tired, and the baby is also, and the kids is really not connected to you. It's much more connected to the nanny, to the yaya, because the kids is always with the yaya, you know. So that's the difference. Here in the Philippines, it's rare that we have yaya. Yeah, because we cannot afford to pay. But there is some that are lucky in their life to afford to have a nanny, I mean. Yeah, so it depends on you how you handled your money. It depends how you trust your wife in such situation like that. It depends on how you act, because as what I have said, we have a very big different culture in terms of money. Number 4, in bedroom. I know if we talk about bedroom, most of you, your ears is really packed, get bigger and much more interested in this topic, because that's wow, amazing. So in this video, we will talk about how Filipina really act in the bedroom. If you already watched my previous video, I really have talked out there that Filipina is really love to have a performer partner. They prefer to have a performer partner because they always wanted, or we always say that performance is mother. We don't mind about your banana if it's big or small, as long as you can give satisfaction. Your performance is very well, even in a very age gap relationship you had. As long as you still have the power to satisfy your Filipina, to give the performance the action that you wanted to have, wow. Always remember that Filipina love performer, especially in bedroom activity. It might be changed if your Filipino will like or love how you drive her crazy. In age gap relationship, it is very common about that DDLG. So what does DDLG really mean? It's daddy dumb little girl. Daddy dumb little girl. DDLG is a type of relationship where your partner takes the rules to be the dominant. The daddy is the dominant and the little girl is the submissive, taking the role of youthful little girl. There are some couples that they prefer to have private, to make private about their DDLG relationship. They don't want to show it in public because they prefer to have it in privacy. And there are also some couples that they want to apply it in their daily life, in everyday's life. Some couple is prefer to have DDLG style of relationship that is non-sexual in nature, which is often used therapeutically for heal the childhood trauma. Thank you so much, Tinkles, for watching. I hope this video will enlighten you in which or what kind of role do you want in your life. It's not always about in bed, but it's always about our daily life. how you want to rule your life with your partner. Do you want to be the dominant of the relationship or the submissive? But I prefer to have both, to also have both, have teamwork and have unity to have a peaceful and happy relationship. So I hope this video will help you to enlighten your mind, open your mind in what kind of rule you want experience in your own relationship. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you give to consider to give a like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thank you. Bye bye, girls. Mwah.